believe this is episode 3 of Factorio. Today I'm just going to be working on making all of this iron and copper mining stuff a lot neater. And I'm just going to get right into it. I'm going to basically start from scratch over here. I'll make this coal go straight up. So now, I have, oh, those are burner mining drills. I have electric mining drills that I need to craft. Make two of those. Plenty of science packs made over here, so I'm gonna go ahead and start some research while I'm waiting on other stuff. That's something you'd like to do, because research takes a while, and if you're ever able to take some time and start some up, you should definitely do that. Okay, now I have my copper drills. They're gonna go right in the middle there. Putting copper onto the belt. And my furnaces. They will all just be neatly placed right here. And I'll actually have these going up. Because afterwards, I can use some of the long inserters. Those will take copper out of these furnaces and put them onto the belt on the far side. Raw copper getting to them, and then there will be coal. I'll just use some of these burner inserters for that. Now I need power. Make a little break in the middle for another pole. Copper. like that'll go over into a chest here so it doesn't build up on the belt. Have plenty of stone for making more furnaces. And iron, we're pretty good right now. We could use another drill or two. I'll have two chests so the copper has somewhere else to go. There we go. And that needs some power. So copper is coming out of these drills and going into the furnaces down here. Then it comes out of the furnaces and goes up into these chests, which are then used to make automation science packs. I'll go ahead and make a few more labs. The more labs you have, the faster research goes. So basically you want to have as many as you can power. And then you'll get stuff done a lot quicker. I think my coal chest is full up here. Yep. So I can just replace that with an iron chest. Looking in here, this steam engine is basically putting out as much power as it can right now, so I'm gonna have to make another one. That way it can keep up with how much stuff I have to power down at the base. And now you can hear it doesn't have to work near as hard. Pump still has plenty of room to go, and the boiler is about 50% capacity, so we're good on power for now. Put the labs down, and those also need power. So now that we have electronics researched, that basically unlocks a few extra things over here. Somewhere. I think that unlocked the radar. Then after you research that, you can do all this other stuff. Eventually we'll need to start making green science packs, which take a few different ingredients. Right now I'm going to start on fast inserters, so we don't have any of this buildup over here. Now we have three labs working on research instead of just one. looks like I need to make some more furnaces for iron. I'll just have that over there for now, before I redo everything again. Okay, so that's basically everything automated down here. We have red science packs being made over here. And now we just need to wait for this research to be done. Okay, the research is finished. Now we have fast inserters and filter inserters. With a filter inserter, you can choose which materials are selected off of a belt or a chest to be moved to a different place. Those are really useful when you combine conveyor belts to move different items. Going to research the logistic science pack. This also will take a little while. After we do that, we're gonna need to make a bunch of assembling machines to make all of the items to craft the logistic science pack. Okay, now the logistic science pack research is finished. So, what that needs to craft is a transport belt and an inserter. And those need all sorts of different things. Transport belt needs iron plate and an iron gear, and an inserter needs an iron plate and iron gear and an electronic circuit. The circuit needs iron and copper cables. So we're going to have to make a whole lot of assembling machines in order to make this all happen. All of this over in a specific area. Oops, need that for iron. So now I'll have up here where there's no ore, because eventually this might run out and I'll need to move it. These will be red science packs, which just needs copper and iron gears. So I'll have copper, over here. Copper is already going into these chests. I'll make it go into the top one. These will be for copper wires. producing that. And then the copper will go up and into the red science pack. Now they need gears. So I'll just have all my gears being made down here, close to the iron. I'll need a lot of those because we need them for the belts and inserters. So there are the gears. Now I need to get them up to the main area. So gears are going onto that belt. And now, first, I'm going to need them for inserters, which also need the circuit. And the circuit needs iron. So I'll have to have another thing, just straight iron coming up eventually. These need coal. That belt will bring me iron. So these wires will go over, and I'll have the circuits being made right next to them. And I want to research logistics so I can have underground belts. Those make it a lot easier to get stuff places because you don't have to take up area on the surface. So iron will come up to these. It will go underneath. Then they will put out the circuits, which need to go to inserters. This will come need some long inserters. So those have wires coming from up here, and iron coming from down here eventually. And they put out electronic circuits. And the circuits will go to the inserters, which will then be right next to here. So we have the circuit belt. Gear belt. And the long inserters take from farther away. And then I'll need iron up there too. Ran out of science packs. Okay, so now we have underground belts and splitter belts. The splitter will take one conveyor belt and put the materials into two. Like this. We'll need that for iron for the inserters. And the underground belts make it go underground. So now that's going underneath the gear belt and going into the circuit assembling machines. Now this iron will need to come up and around and that'll be going in from this side. So now we just need the circuits, which need inserters out of these assembling machines. So now when these get enough wires, they'll start making circuits, and circuits then go onto this belt, and then into these assembling machines, which make inserters. So now we have inserters for the green science pack. We also need transport belts, which just need gears and iron. So I'll have that over here in the forest after I cut down some trees. I'll have this belt split again. I won't have that belt split again. I'll have an underground belt. Actually, yes, I will split this belt again. Just want some extra room. So that'll come up there. And gears will be right here. two assembling machines making belts. So now these have iron from there and gears from there. That all will need power. Now we have our transport belts. Okay, so now we have everything that we need for making the green science packs. I'm gonna end off this episode right there. Next episode, I will finish the green science packs by getting the transport belts and inserters over to here. I will finish the red science packs by getting gears over to there. And then we'll make an automated research system right around here with a bunch of laboratories. And we'll get going pretty quick. That's it for this episode. I hope to see you all in the next one.